And now we're going to learn more about the retained earnings account and how it's affected by changing the fiscal year. Retained earnings is an account that shows the company's total accumulated net income up to and including the prior fiscal year. If you ran a trial balance or a balance sheet, you would not see any income accounts or any expense accounts listed. And if you did, they would all have a zero balance. That's because all income and expenses in a prior fiscal year is reported as zero, and their total netted against each other shows up in the retained earnings account. And now let's look at an example of how this would affect you. In the company file that I created, I put only three transactions. January 1, I put a deposit where I recorded earning income. February 1, I wrote a check to telephone expense for $3,000. And on March 1, I wrote a check for delivery expense for $2,000. Can you figure out the net income of this company for this fiscal year? The net income for the example fiscal year, which in this case is 2017, would be $5,000, as you well know. But just to be clear, the first fiscal year of this company is from January 1, 2017, to December 31 of 2017. Let's take a look at what the reports look like and how they behave. Now, when we take a look at the trial balance in this example company, we can see the money amounts are exactly as what I mentioned a moment ago. The bank account is the only account that has all three of those transactions recorded. And if I double click, you can see the transaction on January 1 was income, and the transaction on February 1 and March 1 were the two expenses for the correct amounts that I had mentioned a moment ago. And I can promise you these are the only three transactions recorded in this file. Now let's take a look at the date pull-down menu. You can see that when you run a trial balance to show the results of all transactions, regardless of date, you will not see a retained earnings account. Watch, if I run any date within this fiscal year, maybe this fiscal quarter, I still see the balances here. What about last month? I still see the balances here. Remember, I'm recording this in June of 2017. So when I click last month, the computer looks at my Windows clock and says, well, the computer thinks it's June, so last month is May of 2017. But all of these choices are just giving me, well, last fiscal year I got nothing. But anytime I run the report within this fiscal year, I see the income and expenses that I mentioned. Unless, of course, I ran it for January or February, but I won't do that. But look what happens when I run it for the next fiscal year. Well, it says here the next fiscal year is January to December of 2018. Notice the income and expense accounts disappeared, and just the net result of the income and expense accounts showed up here in this account, retained earnings. Anytime I run a report after the current fiscal year, I will not see the income and expense. I will only see the net result of them here in retained earnings. So again, this fiscal year to last month, I see everything. If I see yesterday, everything, because I'm still in this fiscal year. The minute I move to next fiscal year, it goes. Even if I made it 2019, okay? As long as the beginning date is after this fiscal year, it will only show the accumulated net income. It will only show the income and expenses all pushed together in this one account that the computer creates called retained earnings. Please note, you cannot post transactions to retained earnings. It is simply an account that QuickBooks creates to show a result. Transactions are not listed there if you try to view the account. So, if I minimize this and I double-click here on retained earnings, you're not going to see the income and the expense transactions listed. This is simply an account that QuickBooks shows instead of showing the income and expense accounts. If you want to see all of the income transactions and all the expense transactions, you would have to change the date range to all, because that would guarantee that retained earnings would not show up. Then you would have to double click each account to see the individual transactions that way. To better understand this, let's add three transactions in the next fiscal year. Let's imagine January 1, income was deposited in the amount of $9,000. February 1, a check for telephone expense was recorded for $4,000. And March 1, a check for delivery expense was recorded at $1,000. Can you guess the net income for the next fiscal year? That's right. It's $4,000 for the second fiscal year, which in this case is 2018. And to be clear, the second fiscal year is from January 1 to December 31 of 2018. Now, when I open the trial balance, after recording those three transactions off camera, you can see when I run it for all dates regardless, the entire accumulated net income for the company is $19,000 for both of the fiscal years, 2018 and 2017. The total delivery was $3,000 and the total telephone was $7,000. And the date of the last transaction is March 1 of 2018. Now, if I run this trial balance from the beginning of 2018, this is the crucial moment, to the end of specifically 2018, I'm isolating only the second fiscal year. Now, when I click refresh, look what happens. Only the income and expense for the current year is listed here. And the previous accumulated income and expense, which we agreed made a net income of $5,000, shows up here in the retained earnings account as $5,000. So if you're looking at a report during only the current fiscal year, all prior year's accumulated income and expenses show up here, and the current year's income and expenses show up in their accounts respectively, but these amounts are only the totals of the transactions in the current fiscal year. Any other income or expense before that would have been accumulated and netted against each other for the computer to give you this number. And again, if you double click, you see nothing, because it is not an account that you can post to. It's simply something the computer is showing you. To be absolutely sure that we're right, we can make the next fiscal year, 2019, and knowing that we have no transactions during 2019, so we will go up to 2019 this way. And now that we, now retained earnings, because this report is showing the results of 2019 and there are no transactions at all during 2019, that means all the income from the two prior years and all the expenses have been put together and in the retained earnings account, and the accumulated net income for both years is $9,000. Now, before we conclude, we will discuss how to change the fiscal year. Normally, you would choose the fiscal year when you create the file. Well, what does that affect? Well, the report date pull-down choices from any report are based on the date set in the Windows operating system. My computer knows, for example, that it is currently June 12th of 2017. So when I run this report, if I put last week, it's going to look at today's date in the computer, June 12, 2017, and show me what is the results of all the transactions during last week based on my operating system time and date. Same thing if I do this, last month. Well, from my point of view, last month was May of 2017. If I put this fiscal quarter, it goes from April to June of 2017, etc. If I do last fiscal year, well, last fiscal year was January 1 to December 31 of 2016. So any of these pull-down choices is really based on the Windows clock or the operating system time and date. You would have to set it yourself if one of these choices are not appropriate. But you can see when you choose a fiscal year, in this case, all it's going to do is change the dates according to the Windows clock. The computer doesn't know exactly what you really set as the fiscal year. So, what do we do? Well, if you change the fiscal year, by the way, you should keep the fiscal year and the tax year as the same. And we will not talk about the details about what is the difference between the fiscal year and the tax year. Just know the conventional advice is to keep them the same. And if you do need to know the difference, you should consult your accountant. Now, here are the choices to change the fiscal year. Main menu, choose company, my company, pencil, and then report information. Let's see that again. Company main menu, then choose my company. Okay, so let's do that. Company main menu, choose my company. Then it said choose the pencil and then choose report information. So I'm going to click the pencil and choose report information. Now I have the opportunity here to change the fiscal year from January to June. And as I said, it's good wisdom to keep the tax year and the fiscal year the same, and your accountant will explain the difference. But it's not important right now. Now the computer thinks my fiscal year begins in June, and I click OK. Now, running a report won't change because anything I choose is going to be based on the Windows clock, but it will affect retained earnings. For example, if I now put the dates of this report from January 1 of 2017, which was the date of the first transaction, to May 31 of January of 2017, I see only the original first year transactions. But look what happens when I change the report dates to be June 1 of 2017 to December 1 of 2017. Now look what happens when I click refresh. Aha! Even though it's still showing the year of 2017, it's showing after the June 1 fiscal year date. So because I changed the date to June 1, or I change the fiscal year to June 1 instead of January 1, now all of the income and expenses are accumulated in retained earnings. If I keep this report open and I go back and I change again the fiscal year to what it was, I'm going to change it back to January. Look what happens. Now that I changed it back to January, the computer looks at this and says, well, it's not the end of the fiscal year yet because it's still within 2017, and it shows the income and expenses instead of showing them together netted against each other in retained earnings.